In 1857, after completing nearly three of the four ring operas, Wagner broke off in order to pursue another subject, Tristan and Isolde. That medieval romance tells one of the most poignant love stories in all of literature, one of a couple drawn together by irresistible love, but separated by duty and honor. Their love inevitably leads to their death when the couple finally achieves the perfect union they could not have in life. Wagner's feeling for the Tristan legend was more than just a matter of literary appreciation. In his exile in Switzerland, he had made the acquaintance of a wealthy silk merchant named Otto Wiesendonck, from whom, of course, he borrowed money. Wiesendonck's wife, a literary dilettante named Mathilde, developed a great admiration for Wagner's art. Indeed, her enthusiasm was such that she persuaded her husband to give the composer further financial assistance and to place at his disposal a house on their estate near Zurich. Wagner and Mathilde were soon drawn to each other, and for a while they met almost daily, exchanging ideas on literature and music. Their friendship probably remained platonic, but that made it no less passionate. Inspired by his attraction to Mathilde, Wagner made Tristan and Isolde a monument to impossible love. The composer wrote, "We recognized that any union between us could not be so much as thought of, and we were accordingly resigned. Renouncing every selfish wish, we suffered, endured, but loved each other." The sense of yearning passion that must suffer and endure permeates the score of Tristan and Isolde. Wagner conveys these feelings through unusual harmonies that impart a feeling of great restlessness by avoiding their expected resolutions. No doubt the most famous instance of such harmony occurs at the beginning of the prelude to Tristan and Isolde. That first chord and its aftermath have been, without doubt, the most frequently discussed harmonic innovation in all of music. Composers and theorists have analyzed it endlessly, attempting to place it in a traditional frame of reference. It won't fit. Wagner has created here a radically new harmonic procedure. Previously, harmony had defined points of known reference for the ear, and the goal of music was to proceed in a coherent way through a succession of these staple points. Let me give you a simple example. Which resolves. It just wouldn't sound complete if the last chord of the sequence was different. But in the opera Tristan, Wagner has all but eliminated harmonic stability. Rather, the harmonies of this prelude remain in a constant state of flux. The initial chord conforms to no conventional type. Its upper three notes form a G-sharp minor triad. But Wagner subverts that chord with an F natural in the bass. Moreover, each note that follows further confounds any attempt to understand the music in terms of established harmonic practice. The harmonies of this prelude consistently avoid resolving to known, stable chords, thereby producing a sense of restless yearning perfectly suited to the psychological tone of the opera. Wagner continues with an impassioned echo of the opening phrase, which leads to a new theme, a noble melody rising in the cellos. Wagner develops this theme for some time, at length arriving at this variation. Notice again the yearning, unresolved quality of the harmonies. How aptly they convey the unfulfilled longing Tristan and Isolde feel for each other. Wagner himself wrote this description of the prelude. From the first stifled moan of unquenchable longing, from the faintest tremor to the free avowal of hopeless love, the heart goes through each phase of futile battling with its inner fever. Wagner continues to spin out this thematic material to form a complex yet unified orchestral tapestry. For example, the next and last distinct theme, though different in pitch and contour, has the same rhythm as the cello melody. Here is the similar cello melody again. Wagner combines these different but related ideas into a superbly composed tone poem, always maintaining that sense of restless longing so distinctive of this work. The music swells to a soaring climax, after which Wagner recalls the mysterious phrase that opened the piece. The remainder of the prelude offers a reprise of its various thematic ideas while dying away towards silence. It seems an intimation that the passion of Tristan and Isolde is not fated to survive this world.